We always keep an eye on culture, and tonight it has a Christmas feel. Why is the Washington, D.C. metro system waging a war on Christmas? Plus, CNN plans to boycott the White House Christmas party. But we begin with Black Lives Matter, which seems to be dreaming of a, I don't know, communist Christmas. Joining us now is Raymond Arroyo, New York Times bestselling author and EWTN news anchor, author of the Will Wilder children's series. Raymond, let's start with this Black Lives Matter issue.
We have to.
Well, yes, we do. Okay. With white organizations and businesses, is it they don't do they not like the phrase White Christmas or
Christmas? No. They want to boycott all white-owned businesses as a way to stop capitalism, as a way to protest against the Trump presidency.
Because all white people like Trump?
I guess.
Mean, even in California, where they all, like a lot of them voted for
Well, the founder of this
Hillary? Group,
one of the Black Lives Matter leaders said something, wrote an op-ed, I think last year, in the Los Angeles Sentinel.
Here's the quote. Rather than lining the pockets of Trump and the other white supremacist capitalists, has a nice ring to it, white supremacist capitalists, donate to black-led organizations that are building new liberatory
structures.
Is that a word? Liberatory? I must have missed that one in school. Liberatory structures in our communities, wrote Malina Abdullah.
She's a professor at Cal State University.
Liberatory. I've learned a new word.
Can you imagine if the Klan came out and said, hey, white people, only frequent white-owned businesses, they would rightly be decried as racist. This has a racist tinge to it that we don't need at the holidays. There's only one color that matters to retail this time of year.
Green.
It's not black or white, it's green. And this is a time of year when everybody comes together. And it also is really dumb because by telling black consumers don't go to white-owned businesses, you're beating up and you're condemning and hurting the black employees at those businesses. This is bad for everybody's
economics. Retail is still, I mean, it's very big this
season. But it's booming this season.
Booming this season. It's not just Amazon. It's not just online. Retail is up. And that hurts everybody. This is what happens is they always take it just too far.
It goes too far. And this is only going to hurt black businesses because what happens? Then only black people will frequent black businesses and white people frequent white businesses. Well, then more white people buying. That's a problem.
Is that what Martin Luther King and Rosa Parks was really all about?
It's terrible. Division at Christmas.
Now, there's just so much sadness in my heart because I understand that CNN won't be at tomorrow's White House Christmas party. There are a lot of media Christmas parties, I guess, or a lot of parties.
Not this year.
Only one media party.
The Trumps are only doing one.
Oh, good for them.
No pictures with the president.
Oh, they're not letting pictures? Oh, boo-hoo. Mr. President, change that.
I know.
Raymond really wants a picture because he wants to meet Melania.
Okay.
Sorry, Rebecca, I didn't mean that. So CNN says they're not going.
CNN is not going.
Who cares? Who cares that they're not going?
Because they feel the president is attacking the First Amendment.
Fake news.
And attacking CNN.
Well, maybe they got a fake invitation then.
You know what happened here? You have a president who, for the first time, is responding regularly to aggressive media.
Unmasking the press.
Well, and look, for good or ill, there's always that tension among the media. That's a good thing, but I think at Christmas time, can't we drop the grudges and come together and have a little eggnog at the White House and get our picture with Melania?
It'll be more fun. It'll be more fun without the CNN people.
Okay.
I'm just kidding. I like some.
Well, that's more cookies.
But by the way, I'm remembering a Christmas past of the Clintons. Didn't the Clintons have an interesting Christmas tree that we've forgotten
about?
Well,
we were talking about this the other day, all the criticisms of Melania's decorations. Remember the Clinton tree, Gary Aldrich's book, the Secret Service guy, who said
there were
condoms and
I can't make
sex
out
toys hanging on
that
tree.
Oh, that can't be true.
That's what he reported.
Condoms aside, I don't believe.
I mean, I'm not going to do the forensic.
Well, that's like a Matt Lauer's Christmas tree
there. You never know what's back there.
Come on. And Obama's Christmas cards. Now we're picking on all the Christmases. We are the Grinches tonight. Now, Obama's Christmas cards, what were those kind of a season's greeting?
They were always happy holidays. No Merry Christmas.
No Christmas.
The Trumps have been very demonstrative in their declaration. The president tonight, even in a tweet, invoked the 2,000-year-old story of Jesus Christ that everybody knows, no matter their religion. This is not going to gain him any more friends at CNN either.
We're putting baby JC back in Christmas.
Yeah, I guess.
Wow.
This is all happening.
Trump's gone away in the manger. This is where we are right now. So finally, Catholic Archdiocese suing the Metro.
Well, they're suing Metro because every season they advertise on the sides of buses. It's a very bland ad.
Let's look at it. Let's show
the ad. The ad just says, find the perfect gift. And it's a couple of shepherds and
okay,
and
we see it. So who's suing to stop it? Or
the diocese wants this advertised.
And they don't want it.
Metro says it's endorsing religion. How
endorsing
is that endorsing religion?
Religion?
It's a couple of sheep. I don't understand.
Given
this.
Some of the ads in the Metro, I think that's about what we need, a couple shepherds.
Well, Merry Christmas. I hope I get my Melania picture.
Oh, Melania.